In today's video, I'm going to be giving you the most important settings that you need to know in Warzone Mobile to get more kills, better FPS, and better visual quality. Now, following these settings will definitely improve your overall gameplay, so I hope you enjoy this one. And ladies and gents, don't forget to drop a like and subscribe, and without further ado, let's hop straight into them. Right then, guys, best settings for Warzone Mobile. That's what you've clicked on the video, so let's get straight into the basics of graphics. Now, this is personal preference, but there are a couple suggestions that I will make here. I'm using an iPad Pro. If you're not using like a very powerful device, I don't recommend using anything above probably medium graphics. But I don't use peak because I like stable FPS. So I play high along with uncapped FPS. Now, performance optimization, you want it for frame rate, not battery. And then, of course, asset streaming. You want this on yes, because this will download all the assets already before like you go into the game and it has to load it individually. Field of view, you want this on maximum, ladies and gents. And then if we go over to controls, this is where things get a little bit complicated, but that's okay. I've got you sorted. Let's break it down real quick just before we jump into the full settings. These three buttons at the top will allow you to basically share your HUD and settings to other players. And it also allows you to rename them and restore them. Now, the thing is with me, I've actually made two sets of HUDs, okay? So I've got this one here. Now, you can copy my HUD by all means. But of course, everybody has their own personal preference with HUDs. But basically, if I go to control sets, I have another one where I've saved, which is default manual. And if I click on this, it's a blank one because this one's for my controller gameplay. Before you guys call me a noob, shush, I play both inputs. But if you didn't know that, you can make multiple control sets and different HUDs. A lot of people coming from Call of Duty Mobile are used to being able to save three different HUD setups, but this way you can save as many as you want. But anyways, guys, settings. Weapon trigger, manual fire, you want to have full control of your trigger disciplines. Auto animations, you want this on custom. What this means is that there are certain settings in the game that will always be on automatic, and you don't want that. You want to control everything in the game, including putting plates on, being able to auto mantle over things and stuff like that. You want full control of everything. You don't want the game playing the game for you. So automations, custom, auto weapon pickup, you want all these on. And the reason I say this is because when you're first landing in, you want to get a weapon as quickly as possible before the opponent. Now, if you've got these turned off, you have to manually click the loot box and then manually look at the weapon and then click on the weapon to equip it. This way it's quicker. But anyways, moving forwards then, guys, weapon auto pickup options, initial slots. It's up to you if you want that, but I like initial slots because it's faster. But if you do use by class, what this means is what weapons you will prioritize on the floor. So do you want to prioritize the ARs over the SMGs? Do you want to prioritize shotguns over ARs? It's up to you, but I like to have this on initial slots. And then turn to damage assist off, loot auto pickup, always put that on. Auto mantle, you want that off. Parachute manual, please put it on manual, because what this means is when you're jumping in, you can deploy your parachute closer to the floor, meaning that you're gonna get to like loot quicker than somebody else. So make sure that you got this on manual. It helps, trust me. Climb stairs buttons, auto crouch, everything to do with this off. You don't want the game playing the game for you. Virtual stick behavior, analog. Sprint to stand is on. Camera rotational mode, you want this on fixed. If you do play accelerated, again, personal preference on this option. But fixed means a swipe of your thumb across the screen will always be the same. Accelerated means if you swipe it faster or slower, it changes the sensitivity depending on how fast or slow you're swiping across your screen. So I prefer fixed. I like to, again, have full control. And then rotational ADS, fire button, throwback button. You want all these off. You don't want these on at all because it will mess up your aim. Weapon mount movement exit on, but you want to put it on short. What this means is when you mount up with a weapon, if you have it on short, you can snap out of it really quickly to kill somebody like behind you if they're coming behind you. If you have it on long, it will take you longer to get off the mount, like the animation. So, short. Weapon trigger, manual fire, auto fire on objects, off, auto fire range limiter, off, single shot behavior, on tap, aim down sights when firing, you want this off. Aim down sight behavior, now this is personal preference. I do like to hold my ADS button because I like to play like I play on a controller, like hold it in, have full control on it. But a lot of mobile players do like toggle. Again, personal preference. Focus behavior, I've actually got this one on toggle. So when you're sniping in, or if you've got an AR with like a long distance scope, then if you wanna like hold your lungs to get like a better aim, you can either hold the button or toggle. Personally, I think toggle's a little bit more better because you press the button and then you've got all your fingers free to press all the other buttons. Auto melee, turn that off. Sprint and door bash on. Force reload off. Force equipped and armor off. Equipped all armor plates. Personally, have this on. I don't know why mine was off. Aim assist, you want that on. Vehicle controls, completely personal preference. Do you want an analog stick to control your car and vehicles, or do you want the arrows, which is up, down, and then left, right on the other side of your screen? Entirely up to you what you want to use there, ladies and gents. Moving on then, outlines. Turn them all off. The outlines just get in your way. It makes the game a lot more arcadey. And when you turn them off, it makes you feel like you're playing the PC version of the game or console version of the game a lot more. I just feel like if you want to fit in with Call of Duty content, you want to turn this off. Interface, left fire display, I've always got that on. Fire buttons while auto fire off. Show ammo, I like to have these separated mainly because it just allows you to be able to like see how much ammo you got a lot easier instead of looking at like small text above the weapon. But again, personal preference. Hit marker display, you want this on. The reason I say this is because if you hit somebody and you've cracked their shields, on Warzone Mobile, it's pretty much like war hacks. If they run around a war, you will see them running with a crack symbol above their head for a few seconds. So turn it on. It helps a lot, especially if people are trying to re-challenge you. Hit marker size, though, on the other hand, turn this to small because large just fills up your vision and takes up like your ADS field of view. And then transparency, I like to have mine pretty low. I don't like to have everything like in my face, like blocking my field of view again. Auto sprint lock, have that on floating, change stance. Now, I like merged. What this means is my crouch button, if I hold my crouch button, it will make me go prone. And if I just press my crouch button, it makes me crouch. So hold to prone and press just to crouch. Now, if you have this on split, it creates another button on your HUD, which is crouch and then prone. They're two different buttons. I personally like to condense my HUD down, have as little buttons as possible. So I like to play merged. Fixed joystick, always have that on. If you've got it on floating, you can really seriously damage your movement by doing so. Invert camera, off. Resupply alert, on. Reload cancel alert, I like these to be on just in case, guys. If you're like too focused on the gameplay, like fighting somebody, at least you have the alerts to let you know what's going on. Sensitivity, personal preference. I like to have a high sensitivity. Yeah, just use what you want to use here, guys. You can copy mine if you like. I do not use gyro, however you want to pronounce it. But ladies and gents, there are my settings. Those were my settings, ladies and gents. If these have helped you out at all, drop a like and subscribe on the channel. I've got a lot more tips and tricks and gameplays to show to you on Warzone Mobile in the near future. And also, if you've got any more tips and tricks about the settings, leave them in the comment section down below. And lastly, if there's any settings missing or settings that was not on your settings, it may be because there's a new update on the game which has released more advanced settings, which I'll cover in another video. Another reason for you to subscribe. Without further ado, guys, I'll catch you in the next one. Peace out.